Good morning, and welcome to Recruit Training Command at Naval Station Great Lakes, the quarterdeck of the Navy. I am Rear Admiral Craig Mattingly, Commander of Naval Service Training Command. I want to personally welcome you to our Navy family. What an exciting day. Family, friends, and shipmates, it is an honor to have you with us as we celebrate the graduation of our newest United States Navy sailors. It seems just like yesterday, I was graduating boot camp, and it meant the world to me to have my family and friends sitting in the audience just like you. I want to take a moment to thank you for playing a significant role in the lives of these sailors before you. Your support, your encouragement, and your love helped them reach this time-honored tradition. As we look upon these young women and men, we see a transformation that took place over the past several weeks. They endured rigorous physical and mental training, pushing themselves to their limits and beyond. They learned the importance of teamwork, of discipline, and of dedication. They have become a proud part of our tradition of service to our nation. Each of these new sailors will play a critical role in fulfilling our Navy's mission. They will be stationed around the world, serving on ships, on submarines, and aircraft, protecting our nation and our allies. Your sailor will make a positive impact on the world. They will be ambassadors of our country, representing the best of what America has to offer. They will be leaders, they will be mentors, and they will be role models for others to follow. And as we celebrate this graduation, let us remember the sacrifices that were made to get us here. Let us honor the commitment and the dedication of these new sailors, and let us look forward to the bright future that lies ahead, knowing that our nation is in great hands. Thank you for playing a significant role in the lives of these recruits, and I warmly welcome you to our Navy family. Enjoy the ceremony and celebrate your sailor. Thank you.
Thank you. We salute the states and territories whose sons and daughters will graduate today.
Delaware.
Pennsylvania.
New Jersey.
Georgia.
Connecticut.
Massachusetts.
Maryland.
South Carolina.
New Hampshire.
Virginia.
New York.
North Carolina.
Rhode Island.
Vermont.
Kentucky.
Tennessee.
Mississippi,
Illinois,
Alabama,
Maine,
Missouri,
Arkansas,
Michigan,
Florida,
Texas,
Wisconsin,
California,
Minnesota,
Oregon,
Kansas,
West Virginia,
Nevada,
Nebraska,
Colorado,
South Dakota,
Montana,
Washington,
Idaho,
Wyoming,
Utah,
Oklahoma,
New Mexico,
Arizona,
District of Columbia,
Puerto Rico,
Guam,
American Samoa,
North America
Islands,
U.S.
Virgin Islands.
State flags,
order,
arms.
And now we invite you to join the staff of Recruit Training Command in welcoming the graduating divisions with your applause as they enter Midway Ceremony and Drill Hall and are announced in the following order.
Thank you.
Division. Right.
Face.
Section. Fall out and collect out of arms. Division. Counter. March. Ready, command.
Division commanders, left or right, face, parade, rest.
Ladies and gentlemen, good morning. I'm Lieutenant Josh Jones, Recruit Training Command Drill Division Officer. I would like to welcome you to today's task review. Today you will see 13 divisions comprised of 1,055 sailors participating in their graduation ceremony and soon join the most powerful Navy in the world. Please draw your attention to the unit position center deck. There is the review commander staff. The review commander is responsible for conducting the graduation ceremony. Today's review commander is Seaman Recruit Christian DeYoung from Sheboygan, Wisconsin. Let's give him a hand, folks. Performing today is the Triple Threat Unit on our 7th week of training, the State Flag Unit on our 8th week of training, and the Staff Unit on our 9th week of training. These units are comprised entirely of recruits. During that arrival, recruits are placed into divisions of 88 personnel and assigned division commanders. Recruit division commanders form the backbone of recruit training and are key individuals in the life of every recruit. Division commanders must serve as counselors, disciplinarians, administrators, and military leaders. Above all, they must show themselves as outstanding examples of military bearing, appearance, attitude, and engagement. Each division also has a recruit chief officer. This senior recruit supervises the divisional staff positions and leads the division in the absence of their division commanders. Now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my pleasure to introduce the graduating divisions, their division commanders, and recruit chief officers. As I introduce each division, they will raise the competitive flag they have earned throughout their training. As I introduce each recruit chief officer, the flag representing the home state will also be raised. Please hold your applause until all introductions have been completed. I will start from there right. Division 1. 9-1. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Gunnar Kazimal. Petty Officer First Class Joshua Henderson. Petty Officer First Class Juan Adams. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer. Seaman Recruit Edmund James from Nashville, Tennessee. Division 1. 9-2. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Chase Ford. Petty Officer First Class Eric Luckett. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Seaman Shane Eiserman from Newburyport, Massachusetts. Division 1-9-3. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Jacqueline Denler. Petty Officer First Class Glenn Lindstrom. Petty Officer Second Class Harrington James. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Fireman Julian Hill from Chicago, Illinois. Division 1-9-5. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Brent Byerly. Chief Petty Officer Coleman Arnold. Petty Officer First Class Mario Rios-Ramos. And the Chief Petty Officer Cindy Lavelle Thompson from Virginia Beach, Virginia. Division 1-9-6. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Carl Sartori. Petty Officer First Class Joseph Diaz. Petty Officer Second Class Sierra Morsch. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer Cindy McCandice Moya from El Paso, Texas. Division 1-9-7. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Justin Rover. Petty Officer First Class Ray Capati. the Oscar Set class, Maya Jeanette Abreu. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Fireman Cole Sullivan from Los Angeles, California. Division 1, 9, 8. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Sally Tao. Petty Officer First Class, Cody Gaines. Petty Officer Second Class, Russell and the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Chase Wilson from Osborne, Texas. Division 199. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Bruce Thompson. Chief Petty Officer Monalilla Thompson. Petty Officer Second Class, Jeremy Jackson. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Aaron Reed Summers from Kennesaw, Georgia. Division 200. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class, Melissa Schulter. Petty Officer First Class, Oscar Fisher. Petty Officer First Class, Jeremiah Johnson. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Apprentice Manuel Che, Las Vegas, Nevada. Division 201. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Zachary Kecker. Petty Officer First Class, Dustin Jones. Petty Officer First Class, Christine Lozada. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Recruit David Porter, Jacksonville, Florida. Division 202. Commanded by Petty Officer First Class, Melanie Henderson. Petty Officer First Class, Manuel Lerner. Petty Officer Second Class, Tyler Alexander. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman David Martinez from Tampa, Florida. Division 203. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Ignatius. Petty Officer First Class, Crystal Cairo. Petty Officer First Class, Manuel Garcia. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Seaman Apprentice Aubrey Bailey from Glenville, Oklahoma. Division 204. Commanded by Chief Petty Officer Daniel Schneider. Petty Officer First Class, Curtis Russell. Petty Officer Second Class, Jesus Monsas. And the Recruit Chief Petty Officer, Airman Apprentice Bradley Smith from Newford, South Carolina. On behalf of the Commanding Officer and Staff of Recruit Training Command, we congratulate these Division Commanders and Recruit Chief Petty Officers on a job well done. This time honored tradition is our formal greeting to this morning's reviewing officer. One such tradition is a gun salute. A gun salute is a huge marking event which to remember honors. Today's reviewing officer will receive arrival honors to include a 15 gun salute. When requested by the announcer, please stand for the arrival honors, marching on the colors, the national anthem, and the invocation. As a reminder, military guests shall remain covered throughout the entire graduation ceremony. And ladies and gentlemen, one final note. As we begin the awards to this occasion, our ceremony is conducted in a formal manner. However, we do encourage you to participate in today's graduation ceremony by letting your applause show these sailors just how proud of them you are. Once again, welcome aboard.
Thank you. The guest may be seated.
Thank you. Board of Captain, I present the graduating divisions requesting assistance from Mr. Rudy.
Good morning, Mr. Rudy.
Aye, aye, sir.
Thank you.
Good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Captain Kenford, Commander of the Recruit Training Command. Welcome to the remaining quarterback. I'd like to welcome our family and friends and attendees of recruit graduation here today, and those watching live from around the world. Joining us today is our commanding officer, Vice Admiral Doug G. Barrett, Commander, Joint Force Command Northern, and also Commander of the 2nd U.S. 2nd Fleet. I'd also like to acknowledge staff from our fleet sponsor, 337th Military Intelligence Battalion, sponsored by Division 191. And the staff include Skipper Urban Henry, Commanding Officer of Surface Warfare Engineering School, and sponsored by Division 196. As well as our guests, we have our own base today, the Flight Administration Team, Louisville staff. Welcome to your equipment as well. Our fleet sponsor, our regular lounge and crews, the Connect Sailors, the AM from around the world, valuable mentoring. I'd also like to welcome all our veterans here today. Thank you for your service to our country. Would all of our veterans please stand and give you a round of applause. Thank you for your service to our country. The staff of recruit training is committed to providing the United States those standing before you today. These sailors successfully completed 10 rigorous weeks of man training and earned the right to wear the uniform recognized as a symbol of freedom around the world. I would also like to take a moment to introduce to you the family and friends of your community family. As you connect your sailor shortly and navigate your new journey together, we invite you to learn more about your community family resources here at Great Lakes around the world. Search the internet for any family, and check out our website for more information about your any family resources. Today's graduates serve as a bedrock for American Naval Forces around the world. Enjoy one of those sails to defend freedom and liberty against those who threaten. I can say we're proud of this training group. This very large training group is ready to graduate. This is now, please make sure to join, because I'm just 1,055 new sharp sails.
This designation reflects a high degree of teamwork, morale, and a spirit of the Corps, as well as superb leadership of the division commanders. Two divisions have earned this honor today, and you congratulate them on a
job
well done.
Captain Joshua Hoffman, Division 203 from Tampa, Florida, has earned the Academic Excellence Award, which is sponsored by the Port Dearborn Chapter of the Illinois Society of Sons of the American Revolution. Fireman Hoffman, receiving the salute of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor! Chase Wilson, Division 198 from Hotboro, Texas, is awarded the Navy League Award, which is sponsored by the Navy League of the United States. Seaman Wilson is presented with the Commemorative Plaque and a letter of commendation from the commanding officer. Well done, sailor!
individuals in the cheers for this morning's award winners.
Throughout the world, the uniform of United States Navy sailor. Anywhere on the globe, maintaining the Navy's high standards. We thank them for their dedication. But most importantly, we acknowledge these sailors' families and friends for the integral role that they have played. You helped shape your recruit into a person who wanted to stand up for their country, who understands the Navy Corps values of honor, courage, and commitment. And during the past 10 weeks, you have tirelessly supported them. We now welcome you into our Navy family. Sailors, you are about to embark on one of the most challenging adventures of your life. You've chosen to serve your country at a time when we need you immensely, when America must show a strong presence, not only here at home, but around the globe, to the world, on the seas, in the skies, under the sea. You've taken on the responsibility of defending our nation, and now you are prepared to take on that tremendous duty. You have earned not only mine, but the respect of a grateful nation. So congratulations, sailors. Welcome to the United States Navy.
Thank you. Please join me one more round of appreciation for our wonderful position at Navy Command Great Lakes.
Flags. Post. Section. Fall out and retreat out of darkness.
Today is the only day for access to the Navy exchange and photo pickup. Today and tomorrow, when you pick up your sailors at the Yorktown parking garage. Sailors going on liberty without a vehicle are to exit gate 8 toward the train station parking lot. Naturalization sailors, please report to the chapel at the conclusion of today's ceremony with your families for the naturalization ceremony. Thanks again to each and every one of you for joining us on this most memorable of Navy days. And without further delay, now, hear this! Liberty Call!